every day when I wake up. I can see his mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, his plans for me is to succeed.
Well, grace and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome to Fresh Start. I'm Pastor Daryl Fair, and I am always excited to begin a brand new day with each and every one of you who log on to this short, but I believe powerful and impactful morning devotional. As a matter of fact, would you do me a favor? Help me grow this faith community by inviting others to be a part of Fresh Start. It is founded out of Lamentations chapter number 3 and verse number 23, where the Bible says that the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is his faithfulness to you and I. And so every day that we know that we are alive, it's another day that God has blessed us with, but it's not an empty day. He has given us grace and mercy. Well, as you know, if you've been tracking with us for the last several days, actually the last several weeks, you know we have been in Psalm 119. And I want us to consider this morning Psalm 119, and let's consider verse number 105. Very familiar passage of scripture to many of us. The Bible says these words, "Thy word is a lamp unto my feet, and a light unto my pathway," or to my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. One of the interesting things for me is when I studied this passage of scripture years ago, I do have a book that talks about the customs of scripture so we can understand the difference between our culture in present day and the culture of those who were in the early days of the church, or Old Testament and or New Testament. One of the things I discovered is that in Bible times, of course, people would still travel at night, but of course there were no street lights, there were no flashlights, there were candles, of course, and lamps, of course. But I found in studying that there were different kinds of inventions for night travel. One of the inventions was a lamp that you could attach literally to your ankle, and it would allow you to be able to travel at night and be able to see the path that you were walking on, even though the sun had gone down and all you may or may not have had is the light from the stars and or the moon. The writer here in Psalm 119, verse 105 says, "Lord, your word is a lamp unto my feet, and it is a light unto my pathway." In other words, I can see where I'm going, and I can see the path that's going to get me there. Let me give you our fresh focus for this morning. It is simply this: my destiny is not clothed in darkness. God's word gives me revelation and illumination. Let me say that again. My destiny, your destiny, it's not clothed in darkness. It's not shrouded in mystery. God wants you to know it. And the Bible says his word indicates that it's going to give us revelation, and his word is going to give us illumination. In other words, God's word will allow me to have access to know where the path is, and then God's word is going to light the path that I take toward my destination. There are many people who pray, "God, give me your will, give me an understanding of my destiny and my purpose." And there is absolutely nothing wrong, in my opinion, with that prayer. However, this particular psalm tells us one of the ways that we can uncover or discover our destiny and our purpose, it is through the word of God. So I want to encourage each and every one of you who are watching, in particular this morning, that maybe you're trying to figure out, okay, what move should I make? What What step should I take? It almost sounds like that old, I believe it's an old James Cleveland song. What shall I do? What step should I take? What move should I make? Oh Lord, what should I do? And I can't help but be me. But one of the things that we've discovered is God's word will give us access to know what move to make, what turns to take. And so I want to encourage you to find your direction in the Word of God. As a matter of fact, someone put that quickly as we close. Put it in the chat area. I find my direction in the Word of God. I don't have to go to Who's Famous. I don't have to go to Instagram to find my purpose and my destiny or my destination. I find my destination, my destiny, my purpose in the Word of God. Well, I hope that this made sense this morning, and I trust that I'll see you tomorrow if it is the Lord's will. As we close out, let me speak this over your life. Whatever you had to face on yesterday, just know God has allowed you to outlive your yesterday, and God has brought you into a brand new day full of His grace and full of His mercy. And so as you and I step into this brand new day, just know God's going to give you clear direction out of His word. God bless you. I'll see you in the morning. The gospel.